I always talked about doing this expeditiously. Someday my wife is gonna understand nothing she's ever done helped God, was of God, or served God. She was serving the devil. It'll be a hard lesson for her, because she'll sit there and forgive me, forgive me, forgive me, and forgive me. And I'll sit there the entire time. I don't know you. It'll be a hard lesson for her. To me, I told her a long time ago. I really did. I just looked at her a long time. She was talking so much shit that I sat there and I was like, you must not know about me. I was like, everything you've said, I have heard. Everything you've done, I have witnessed. You must not know about me. Right? So I was like, do you not even get that I'm playing with you right now? I do not care. I don't think you know that about me. Like, you must not know about me. I sat there, I was like, you're talking to Jesus Christ himself. My wife was sitting there like, I don't care, I'm talking to Jesus Christ himself. Okay. All right. I was like, I don't think you actually get what I'm actually trying to communicate to you. Like, and two, like, who the fuck were you talking to that told you you could talk to me this way? Well, I thought that I can, yeah, you thought that. You thought that. Me and God were sitting there like, what'd she say? She said that again? I'm sitting there like, all right, there's only so much I'm gonna take of this. Like, I'm really on my last nerve when it comes to you. You must not know me. You must not know me, because I'll put you to the left. I'll replace you in a second.
Go ahead.
I really woke up. I was like, fuck this broad. I don't care anymore. For real. I had to fight my way out of it. I was like, I don't care who she's fucking, who she's talking to. I do not care anymore. She created this entire situation. She'll deal with it. I do not care. Like, she did this to herself. So, you know, I wanted to bring love and things into her life. She destroyed all of that and decided she was going to do it herself. Fuck her and everybody she knows. There we go. You don't believe me? Watch it.
I want you to take your Bibles out and I want you to turn to John chapter 8. John chapter 8. I'm only asking you to turn to one passage. Although we'll look at some others today. So John chapter 8. And we are continuing our series called Face to Face, Divine Encounters. And this is a little strange, the title. We started with like John's story and Mary's story. And Pastor Preston did Matthew's story. And then we had to kind of describe the people because we didn't know their story. The lame man's story was 1 week. This is, we don't know her name, the adulteress's story. That's really all we know about her, was she was caught in adultery. So, the adulteress's story. All right, John chapter 8, look at verse 1. John 8, verse 1. But Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. Now, early in the morning, he came again into the temple. And all the people came to him, and he sat down and taught them. Then the scribes and Pharisees brought to him a woman caught in adultery. I want you to notice this word caught. And when they had set her in the midst, they said to him, Teacher, this woman was caught in adultery in the very act. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned, but what do you say? This they said, testing him, that they might have something of which to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down and wrote on the ground with his finger as though he did not hear. So when they continued asking him, he raised himself up and said to them, here's a very famous line from the Bible, he who is without sin among you, let him throw a stone at her first. And again, he stooped down and wrote.
Done so many times that I'm actually exhausted by it now. I really am. She has no regard for God. She doesn't love God. She doesn't follow God at all. But she speaks as she does, right? So I was going through her entire lifetime like, who is this broad that I'm supposed to marry? Bro, she got in her head that it was a blessing for me to marry her. I sat there the entire time. Who is this broad that I'm supposed to marry and why? Ain't nothing happened. God's like, move. Fucking man, what do you want? You want a different one? I was thinking about it, I was like, all I gotta do is pull that spirit out, put in another person. Like, fuck it, dude, I'm down. Fuck this bro. This, you haven't understood what she's actually done to me. And then she wants to talk all kinds of shit, like, now I want to get married, and I'm, fuck that dumb bitch. Like, that is me and God's perspective on it. For real. You want to ask me? I'm telling you, flat out, fuck that dumb bitch. God has never liked her in the first place. That'll be a hard thing for her to learn, but... I even told her, I was like, the Holy Spirit doesn't like you. Do you understand this? She was like, well, you're the devil. We were looking at her like... By your own words. Stupid bitch. Seriously, I'm gonna upload this. I was like, we were sitting there like, I'm gonna put
this
you.
This level is accepted at 99% of places in the U.S.
Even God himself was sitting there watching everything that she did. It was, and she was sitting there like, I'm gonna be a godly woman. I'm gonna do this and all this. No, all of us knew you. And we're like, no, you're not. You're not a godly woman, and no, you are not. We know you. You abandoned your God and your husband. We know you. She's sitting there like, well, the devil is attacking me. Everything that you've lived your entire life caused all of this, and you're getting pissed off about the devil? That's your homie. That's your husband. Stay with your husband. I don't want you. That's my decision. I'm done with this thing, bitch. I'm done with her. Hey, that was your last. Here you go.
I've been sitting here staring at the clock on the wall.
You ain't talking to me no more. I'm done with this bitch. I'm done with her. That's it. All right. You good? All right.